Welcome to the very first episode of Fellowship Gamers. Here with me today is my long lover, just kidding, just my best friend,
Joe Emery.
So today we're going to be playing some Kerbal Space Program. I played this game a few times before.
I've seen it been played once, and it was great.
It was great. We had a lot of fun. I'm not very good at this game.
So it's not a lot of messing around, like the 900 hours of GTA 5 I put in.
But, I've never played the actual game. I just went into Sandbox and played a lot of that. So, I guess we'll see how it goes.
Are we trying the full game or just...
No, we're just going to do Sandbox because the full game seems a little bit just too complicated, you know? Yeah. For my skill set, I mean, I'm basically a rocket engineer, as you'll see in about 2 seconds, but...
I mean, we did watch one Adam Savage video and he created a rocket ship in one day, so... You know,
true. Like, I mean, if he can create a rocket ship in one day, we can create... several that work
and
flawlessly.
You know, I've listened to Ariana Grande's NASA song multiple times.
Exactly.
You know,
so I think that basically makes us. I think that basically makes us qualified to be rocket engineers.
This whole YouTube thing doesn't work. Yeah.
We're gonna send our applications into NASA qualifications. Watched a few videos and listened to an Ariana Grande song.
Killed a thousand. Kerbals.
Killed at least 1,000 Kerbals. This is the vehicle assembly bay. This is where we'll start building a rocket ship of great proportions. For me, I mean, you just always got to start with the essential pod. I don't know which one's the right pod ever.
They're all right. You wouldn't put a wrong one in here, would they?
Probably not. I think this one looks most like NASA, you know?
Yeah, that's what I picture.
Uh-huh. When I picture the NASA rocket ship, I picture...
the tip?
The tip. How do I... As you can see, I'm very good at this game.
Very skilled.
I don't know how to move this up. What the freak? Okay, well, our rocket ship's gonna have to be that high, because... that's all of our space we have to work with, because I don't know how to move it up. I don't know.
It's going to be a tall boy.
I mean, a short boy, really. Because, I mean, we got all this room, yeah. And we're using the bottom quarter. we're using this much space.
That's true.
Ooh, it's got 100 will authority. Which is good, right?
I'm guessing.
If anything I want on a rocket ship that's going to be in space, I want it to have will authority. Because if it doesn't have authority over those wills that it's not going to be using, what's even the point? You know?
Totally.
Alright, so I guess we gotta fit something on there. That looks too circle. That fits perfect, right?
Besides the little side, you know, just that's where the air goes through. Isn't that how rocket works? You need a little
aerodynamics.
Little air.
I mean, we got the qualifications for it, you know. So, I think this more goes. No. Not at all. No, this
looks
is
like
the one.
The store today.
That's the one,
yeah,
right there.
That definitely goes bad.
So we'd add a few things on there. Hopefully that's enough room for an engine. I mean,
are those all the? Is that the fuel tanks?
Yeah.
So just enough to carry all those wheels to space.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, that's the one. Why is it like that? It's so stupid. Why make a rocket ship flat on the side? mean, I'm probably aerodynamics or something.
Make it an extra, like, foot off so you don't, like, run into meteorites. I skipped that class.
I skipped that Ariana Grande song.
I sneezed during that second.
And then probably add some fins on there, you know.
Fins are important. Fins are definitely important. They give you the finishing touch.
Oh, got them. Because, I mean, if we put a fin right where that stupid thing is...
It's not going to work.
Boom, that will change how aerodynamic our rocket is. And then we need to put...
I will say that it's super nice that you can duplicate that, so you can put multiple on one time, so you're not, like,
I know, seriously. Thank you, Kerbal Space Program, for adding that feature, but not adding the feature to be able to move your rocket up once you placed it down.
Maybe this is, like, the starter. Like,
oh, wait.
They ain't just going to give us authority to make the biggest rocket out there. Right off the bat.
I'm a genius.
Don't drop it.
Don't drop it. We just move it up. It just falls to the ground.
Kills everybody.
I think we need to... We definitely need to start closest to space for this chicken.
You can't go too high. It's not going to go out those doors.
Rip. You're right.
I mean, I really don't think the game's too picky about that, but...
Yes. Perfect. That is what I call aerodynamics right there. I mean, if we... I think this is it.
There's nothing better. This is going to work.
Yeah.
This is going to get the future Kerbal children of America to space.
We'll name it... Future Kerbal Children.
Yeah, that's perfect. Straight from NASA.
Straight from NASA.
I'd like to see a name generator do better.
Seriously, though. And then you just got to add the mark. The mark one. That.
Or just mark?
No. Riff. Just dig it. All right. Don't mind me. I'm just the best typer on the planet. Kerbal Future.
Children.
Children.
That's totally right.
Well, that's not future.
It's not future. Spell future without you.
Got him. Future children, mark one. All right.
That's
description. We're the kids of the future. Whoa. That's a classic song from Disney Channel for all you youngins out there.
I think those tips will work like a propeller.
Yeah.
Help you get straight, stay straight.
Because we know aerodynamics, because we listened to that one Ariana Grande song. So we know. We know that.
Did you go through and turn all those power buttons on before?
Yeah. Because, I mean, I know because I've listened to that song, you know. Because that's what she says in the song.
Don't forget the power button.
Remember. Don't forget the power button on all the fuel containers. You slow it down and play it in reverse. It's just, don't forget the power button.
It's all 961 pages of the NASA space program.
Just sung like in 3 minutes. That's why you gotta slow it down.
She's very talented.
She's very talented. She knows her words very well. To create the entire space manual.
Did I ever tell you I met her one time?
Really?
At the Air and Space Museum in Washington, D.C.
Really?
Really. I met the whole cast of Victorious.
Really?
Except for Victorious.
Except for Victoria.
We were there for like a... It was like a Nickelodeon like concert thing. It was weird. And I was there from my like, sixth grade like field trip at Pinnacle. The one thing they ever did right was just send us all to Washington. Like they had no money.
Seriously, that's like
else, but to send us there.
And yeah.
I got to meet them. It was pretty cool.
The coolest field trip I went on sixth grade was going to like jump on it up north. We got like an hour to jump on the trampolines. That was it. Then we went home. Then we went to Thanksgiving Point.
Well, it's not like we didn't have to pay for it. It was definitely like a $750 road trip that I had to pay for.
But I mean, you gotta go to Washington D.C. That's worth.
Yeah, it was really cool.
So Mark 1, it doesn't work. It's not flying. We got her full throttle. What did we do wrong?
You forgot the power button.
We have all the components. The fuel, the cockpit.
Do we have people?
Yeah.
Jedediah, Bill, and Bob. Standby.
And Valentina.
Valentina.
Valentina. They're all 5 stars, so that's great.
Children of the future.
I seriously don't know why this doesn't work, though.
A few moments later.
Look at that. They're still alive.
Look at that. Look how perfectly balanced it is on the freaking thing.
That looks like something Lego would
build. Seriously. My mouse stopped working.
Rude. 1 second.
All right. Thank you, Razer, for making quality mouses. Mice. For me. For just breaking every 20 minutes, I swear. Thank you, Razer. I still buy all your products.
At least they all match.
Yeah, that is the most important thing of all. It's that they match. And that's what we need in life. All right, let's launch our spaceship. So this is going flawlessly. I mean, look at that freaking cloud of dust. That's what you want to see. You really want to go for spectacularness rather than usefulness.
Definitely.
And I think
I like look. You know, if I'm gonna die, I like to look good.
Mm-hmm. Like,
I'm not like a boring spaceship.
Like in this area, where all of these people are at, like. Assuming people are watching. I mean, they're all dead, but at least they got a hell of a show.
Yeah.
You know?
For real. This is the closest you'll ever get to, like, Dragonfire.
Yeah.
Like
Game of Thrones? Know. Hit me up.
Yeah.
We know how to make Dragonfire. I mean, look at that.
Season 9 coming soon.
See, this was full of people. Now they're all gone.
See?
Dead.
Thanos.
Just like my mother. Just kidding, she's alive and well. Well, I think our problem here was...
Everything.
Everything.
We're missing a fuel tank right there. Where did that go?
Yes, we are. I don't know.
Is that the one that exploded?
Could have been. Probably.
This is the fuel tank, and you just set it sideways. Oh, yeah. It wasn't even attached to it. Maybe that was the problem.
From here, from the bottom fin to the top of the rocket... We've done everything wrong.
I think you can imagine.
Everything I learned from definitely not Ariana Grande song. No. Because we just
she does everything.
Yeah, she just we just threw out the rules on this one. Like what? No, we are that's what? Why can't I place these now?
Do you still have that other ship on the side?
Do we have to start? Do we start with the fuel tank before?
No, we started with the top.
That's what I thought.
The cockpit.
Why have we ruined every single bit of this game already? Should we just make a big old boy?
Yeah.
That's what they do in that. So they say, hey,
bigger the better.
Let's make a. What the freak? What did we do? I don't understand.
Is there a way to like change the size of? Like, I feel like that should be an option, because...
Like, well, we ran out of money.
Is that why?
I thought we were on Sandbox.
Do we still have money? No, there's, like, $8.
Because we had, like, 10,000 down here, and we only have 1,250.
That whole spaceship only cost, like, 9,000.
Yeah.
That's impressive. Well, I mean...
Yeah.
That's probably why I didn't go to ship it. to space. It wasn't us. It was the cheap ass material.
Seriously though, like NASA puts in what, like $6 billion into every rocket they make. We put $9,000. We're like, that's going to space.
We will build your ships for less.
For less. What's what? What place is that? Is that Walmart?
Shop for less. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's Walmart.
No, Walmart's save money, live happier, isn't it? Or something like that.
I'm pretty sure Walmart is shop a lot, live less.
Shop a lot. Buy a lot. Just be in the Lego section all the time. Feeling blind legs.
For hours. And hours.
Okay, well, we'll be back, I guess.
We are experiencing technical difficulties. Please stand by.
When we played before, I was able to build whatever. But now it's letting me again. I don't know. I think we broke the game somehow.
For a second? Possibly. I mean, we did go to that other room, and we had never been there before. What is that?
I don't know. It's a fuel tank of some sort.
Oh, they look like a
life preservers?
Yeah, life preservers. I can't think of it. For the life of me.
Got him. Just add a
flag. That looks like everybody... going in there is like infected with something, and they have to go through like one of those tubes, like an ET. Like, you just gotta walk through it.
I think I'll let us put a rocket on the bottom of this. I mean, it's hollow, so it makes it lighter, yeah. So it's gonna go up faster.
Yeah.
And it's gonna make it to space.
You think you could shove like one of those skinny ones right up in the middle and then put the rest around it?
I don't know, but that's freaking the greatest idea.
That just that looks like a slinky.
Oh, it's too fat. Too fat. And then we just, I don't know, we put... I mean, you try the... Holy, yes.
That's gonna work.
That's how we get to space, right there.
I mean, you'd think the wind would hit that, but not at all.
No, because... Ariana Grande, remember?
Yeah,
you know what we're doing. You know what we're doing. Ariana Grande, if you're out there, thanks for all the wisdom you gave us. I swear, if this works. What? I'm so confused.
It looks like a candle.
Why did the last one not...
Oh, we got a little slinky action there. That didn't last at all.
Like, I know, that
burned
was...
up all the fuel tanks like that.
Maybe we should go for a smaller engine. But look at that. We're like, look how high we made it in like no time whatsoever.
That was definitely a lot farther than. Are we just stuck there now?
I think we're on the downscent.
Yeah.
The downscent. The descent.
The downscent. Is that like downwind?
Yeah. That's when you're downwind and you get that downscent. Let's see if they land it. I mean, I think they got it. They're gonna, if this lands right back on where we landed, we launched from. I mean,
he's dead. Jedediah's dead.
That's a success. That's as successful as.
Nope.
I thought the fuel tanks was gonna act as like shocks, and it was gonna like bounce back up. But, I guess that makes sense that they exploded.
Just acts like shocks and just... That's how you got to space. It's just the bounce. Back from space, it just goes straight.
That's great. What is that, though? The lurking demons? Are demons of the past that... they know we've killed all the Kerbals? So I think the solution here is to... raise it up. And then we just put, like, what, 60 of these on there?
Yeah.
So.
Yeah,
boom. This might be a while.
Yeah.
2 hours later.
I like how the shadow just, like, every time you put one, it just inches forward. Like that one walking right in front of him is just gonna get cut.
You just see him just get absorbed into the ground. We're really just creating a portal to hell.
That truck just ran, like, three of those guys over. He, like, waited for one to pass and then just ran three of them.
That's what I paid him for.
A few inches later.
Boom.
Nice.
And we made a giant space dick. Tiny balls.
His balls. That's right.
His balls are on the side. His dick. That's okay.
Happens to everybody.
Alright, this is it. This is the moment you guys have all been waiting for. Check it out next episode.
Oh my god. No! That is the best thing I've ever seen. That looks like when you're walking and you, like, trip over a hose and it just falls off the shelf and it's just, like, flopping in the wind and you're just like,
That's 30 minutes of my life I'll never get back.
Look how happy Jedediah is about not dying.
Yeah. I mean, he didn't die, so technically that was successful.
Yeah. Every time we don't have to pay $1 billion in lawsuits, it's good.
That's a good rocket. It's a good rocket right there. Let's see. I think there's, I know how to fix this.
Kerchoo.
Kerchoo. We built, what, two different rockets.
Two.
And, neither of them have come close to getting to outer space.
This one costs $43,000, and that's just in fuel.
I really was hoping that would work. I think it's just too heavy. I think we need to give it more rockets.
Do you think the balls have to do with something? Like, are they just, like, too heavy on one side?
That's me when I'm bored in class with my pencil.
I thought you were talking about just your balls on the side.
I was like, for me when I'm bored in class, I just like to shift my balls to the side.
Seems about right.
Oh my god, why don't they go straight? God damn it. Oh, because it's trying to put it on, like, each and every one of those things.
I see.
Well, I can't see this going wrong at all.
This has gotta work.
It's actually, like,
really cool.
Oops.
That's wrong.
Like, this looks cool. Therefore, shall perform cool.
I feel like you might need to put some of those, things on it that hold it up as well.
Struts.
Because I feel like it's still gonna be wavy.
Yeah. Right.
Whereas those are only attached to, like, one or
let's
two at the most.
Let's put it at, like, the halfway point, you think?
Yeah.
Should we do it all the way?
Let's do half.
Half. Okay.
let's try it.
The top is just gonna flop over.
I mean, unless you can hurry up and just... Nope. Maybe we need to go to the top with this.
Hey, that one made it pretty far this time, though.
68 meters?
Dang it. We needed to go 1 meter higher. And we would have achieved the ultimate height.
69.
Got him. Alright. Well, at the top we go. This is the last thing we'll try. If this doesn't work, then...
We'll call it an episode.
Yeah.
Let us know if you want us to do another game of this, or...
If you've enjoyed this episode, like, comment, and subscribe. Fellowship Gaming.
All this the way. Is...
God damn it. Wait. Wait for it. Wait for it.
Oh.
That one. 68 again. Do you think that's just how tall it is?
Yeah.
That's probably true. Well, as we say goodbye to Jedediah.
And Bob.
And Bob. And Bill. And Valentina.
And Jedediah. He survived quite a bit.
Jedediah was a real trooper on this one.
He had 5 stars.
He had five stars, and he was in.
But you don't just give up with the name Jedediah.
You don't.
You live through some stuff.
Mm-hmm. And that's what matters.
Yeah. That's all that matters.
We take our hats off to you, Jedediah. We salute you. We surely we'll miss you.
Yeah. You're a trooper.
I just want you to know that I hope you're doing good in the afterlife. And we'll try harder next time. Maybe your son will follow in your footsteps. Jedediah Jr.
JJ.
JJ.
Little JJ.
Little JJ. Come to the astronaut flight facility. We'll do good, but if you guys enjoyed this, maybe we'll do more episodes. I don't know. It's a pretty fun game. Maybe we'll do some challenges, maybe try to get into space. Should be our first challenge. Build a rocket ship that makes it higher than 68 meters.
Well, we'll definitely be back with this or another random game you've never heard of.
Yeah.
Definitely.
For sure. And with that...
Signing off.
Signing off. Fellowship Gamers.